Hello and welcome to part one of this 1D Seismic MASW training series. I'm your host Stefan Burns, I'm a geophysicist, and in this first overview video, we will cover the basics of surface waves. There are many different geoscience applications for surface wave analysis, and active and passive methods exist. The active seismic methods are SASW, or spectral analysis of surface waves, and MASW, multi-channel analysis of surface waves. Well-known passive seismic methods like REMI and SBAC are classified as MAM, or microtremor array measurements, and the other well-known passive seismic method is HVSR, or horizontal to vertical spectral ratio. All the units in these training videos are metric. Surface waves are a type of seismic energy that propagates horizontally along the ground surface, and they dominate the seismic energy spectrum, with two-thirds of seismic energy typically existing as surface waves. Surface wave velocity closely follows shear wave velocity, and the benefit of using surface waves is that they are abundant passively, easy to generate actively, exist at low and high frequencies, and their dispersive nature allows for observations of shear wave velocity geologic structure over a wide range of depths from the top meter of the subsurface to kilometers down. There are two types of surface waves, Rayleigh waves and Love waves. Love waves are surface waves with horizontal displacement perpendicular to propagation direction. Rayleigh waves displace vertically and horizontally parallel to propagation direction. The applications for Love waves are relatively new and outside the scope of this training series. And for all these videos, when we say surface waves, we mean exclusively Rayleigh waves. Surface waves dominate the seismic energy spectrum because of their high amplitude. Surface waves can be generated actively by impacting energy into the ground, or they can be recorded passively, as naturally existing microtremors which propagate through the Earth are easily recorded with modern seismographs. The 1D MASW method utilizes surface waves to generate a 1D shear wave velocity profile. This model will plot shear wave velocity data points from zero to a max depth, which is calculated from the lowest frequency surface waves detected. A seismograph will record the frequency and velocity of all seismic waves that it encounters, and it can split the unified wave data it records into many constituent waves of calculated velocity, amplitude, and frequency by using a Fourier transform. A Fourier transform decomposes raw seismic data, which then can be plotted as a frequency phase velocity diagram. Active source MASW can generate surface waves with wavelengths of 1 to 50 meters, which have a frequency of 5 to 50 hertz. Very high energy sources like explosives can generate even lower frequency surface waves. Applications for active MASW include VS30 site classification, foundation engineering, void detection, landfill investigations, and geologic studies. Passive seismic MASW, also called microtremor array measurements, records microtremors of all frequencies, with the dominant frequency band being 0.2 to 30 Hz. Passive surface waves have wavelengths of a meter to kilometers in length. Passive MASW, or MAM, can be used for VS30 site classification, foundation engineering, and deep geologic studies. For active MASW, the primary energy source used is either a sledgehammer or a heavier propelled weight drop. A heavier sledgehammer impacted harder will create higher energy surface waves. A steel or aluminum strike plate will generate higher frequency surface waves as compared to a rubber or polyethylene strike plate. Larger surface area strike plates create lower frequency surface waves. Passive seismic surface waves, or microtremors, are created from human activities and natural phenomena, such as wind and water flow. In coastal areas, sea waves create easily distinguished low-frequency surface waves. Wind blowing over plants, trees, or taller structures, causing them to sway, creates passive surface waves. Microtremors propagate from all directions, and depending on the nearby environment, microtremors might primarily propagate in one direction, for example, propagating perpendicular to the strike of a road with active car traffic. When planning a passive MASW survey, Using survey geometry which best accounts for local surface waves results in better data. Since microtremors propagate in all directions and the propagation angles are unknown for direct calculation of phase velocity, then the spatial autocorrelation method, or SBAC method, can be used to calculate phase velocity for the different frequency surface waves recorded. Thank you for watching this 1D MASW overview training video. In training video 2, we discuss 1D active MASW field setup and data acquisition. In training video 3, we process 1D active MASW data using SeisImager surface wave.